Quigley on the Rachel Zoe Project.
It's ironic that you would do your first cover. She ran runs for
beautiful Rachel. That's it. Perfect. That's it. Hold on.
Dad's worried. I'm worried. We're all worried. Everybody's worried, but I still have so many things that have to be done. The baby comes first, no matter what. Remember?
I know.
You have to do my makeup for the hospital.
Well, did you ever, like, think of that hospital thing on you?
Yeah.
I love it.
I'm going to try and transition to maybe creating and cultivating Rachel Zoe Home.
As a company, we need to figure out if we have the need.
I thought I was going to come in here today, and you're going to look at me and be like, you've been working your ass off. You're dedicated. You get the job done.
You're the home authority of a company that doesn't do anything at home.
Today, here and now, the day-to-day just is going to probably have to end.
But it's just not hopeful.
Hey, Johns.
You need to go back and think this through and let us know what your best offer is, and then I can look at it. If it's not better, then I'm just not going to waste anyone's time. Thank you.
Like a soothing of the apps to everybody.
Oh, girl.
Huh?
Hi.
How are you?
Okay, what are you doing?
I have a meeting with Roger.
Did he tell you about Jeremiah?
No, what happened? Like, let him go, like, fired him?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Look, I mean, Jeremiah came on because everybody was like, we need help, we need help, we need help. And he came on, and I don't think he ever really had, like, any sort of direction on what he needed to do. And, you know, when he did the house, and he killed it, and everybody was like, oh, my God, like, this kid's a genius. Like,
yeah.
Why are we wasting everyone's time teaching him how to, like, steam clothes? I mean, I just don't think he's seeing it the right way. Like, I think he's like, I was fired. I'm like, well, you weren't fired because you sucked at your job. You were fired because we think that you're too talented to be an office assistant. Like,
for
I think
sure.
He thinks, like, oh, we weren't happy with him. And I'm like...
Well, what do you want him to think? Like, he got fired. If I got fired, I would start crying.
Yeah, I don't think that's what Roger was saying. I think Roger was saying, like, this job doesn't make sense for you.
Right, but all I would hear is that I no longer work here, and I'd be sad. Like, I totally feel for him.
I think that he'll make a lot more money and have, like, a much better future if he just did something that he's really good at.
Should we throw him a sorry for your last party?
Can we make it Mexican themed so you can have guacamole?
He's gonna be like, can we have a section where we can build stuff? And my nails can get dirty.
I know. Every time I see it, I'm like, did you not shower this morning? He's like, I was painting something. I'm like, bitch, you painted 4 days ago. Go take
a like, how do you expect to touch, like, $50,000 gowns with, like, dirt in your nails?
He, like, stores paint, like, in his house.
It's way weird.
All right, dude. I'm gonna go check on Jeremiah. I can get off this goddamn table.
Well, we have a meeting with Roger.
I told him I can't come. He wanted me to meet with Jared and kind of hash it out. Love you, bye.
Love you, too.
I need a snuggle.
Okay, bye.
See you later.
Hola.
Hello.
Hi, Raj.
Holy heat wave outside.
I know, right?
Did I mention how much I love living here?
How's Rachel doing?
She's good.
Aren't we super, super close to the actual due date?
Yeah, she's full term, so any day now. Rachel is basically on sabbatical. Just don't talk to Rachel about any jobs.
Yeah.
Jobs that come up, jobs that don't come up.
What if it's a really important job, though?
What's more important than my child? Just filter everything for me. I need her to just chill.
Is there a memo that I missed? I've never seen Rachel relax in her life.
Joey's right, but this isn't a joke anymore. Rachel's having a baby at any moment, and she needs to make sure that she's physically and mentally ready for it. We really have to get the bag packed.
Totally.
Have to do that.
All right, I'm going actually shopping for it today, so. Should I pack some Chanel earrings, since she said she'd always give birth in Chanel?
I think she said she's
going
to
give birth.
Buried in Chanel.
No, I think she said she's going to give birth to Chanel.
Excuse me.
Seriously, though, no work for Rachel. Social, like, hey, how you feeling, honey? Do you want some soup? Whatever, that's totally acceptable. But don't, you know, copy her on emails. Don't inquire about jobs. Nothing. She needs to just get her mind off everything. The only thing that's important is getting baby vermin out. Mm-hmm.
Jody.
Nothing.
Thanks for coming to see me, though.
Of course. How are you doing? Jeremiah asked me to meet him for coffee, and it's typically very hard for me to leave the office, but I guess I feel a little bit responsible for his firing. I recommended him for this job, but I'm still his friend, and I want to be there for him.
I don't know how to feel about it. I'm just all over the place. Yeah. It's hard because I don't like being fired.
You weren't fired because you did a bad job.
No, I know.
And that's, like, what you need to get into your brain.
It's even weirder, though, to have somebody be like, you did a really great job, and you're really great at this. We're going to let you go.
But you're great at something other than what you came in to do.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I can't employ people that aren't using, like, their greatest potential.
I didn't really even get the chance to actually be a stylist for
them. I think that you need to, like, stop wallowing. Because I personally, I don't feel bad for you.
No, but I don't think I'm wallowing. I think I'm just trying to take it all in. You know, it just sucks because there's so many different avenues that what I want to do for her as far as, like, home or interiors or lifestyle. There's so many different places that can happen to the brand.
We have not sold one tank top yet. Like, our clothing is not in stores. So, like, to have you be like, I'm going to make a sofa, like, that makes no sense. And it doesn't mean that you're not great, but just because you're great doesn't mean that I have to launch, like, a huge business that could tarnish our brand. It's a perspective issue. Like, you have to take away what you gained from this experience.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, to leave here and say, like, I did reach this house. Like, you have this huge endorsement, and you have people that believe in you.
It's just nice to talk to you guys to get your perspective on everything. I just don't want to leave there feeling as though I somehow let people down when I was giving it everything I had.
I don't feel that way. I think that you were honest with your intentions. You didn't, like, leave them and try to be them, and you didn't steal from them. So, like, those little tidbits.
I still got fire.
Sure.
I know.
Hey, dolls.
Hi, Kendall. How is it going?
We're prepping the Halston and the Chanel sweaters because the pregnant lady should be comfy and cozy and fabulous.
Oh, my gosh.
She's wearing Chanel and Halston to the hospital.
Do you know who this woman is?
It's almost like we're prepping for a photo shoot rather than a hospital stay, but sadly, I've been here long enough that this seems completely normal.
Do you think she'll get paparazzi'd when she leaves the hospital? Are you packing clothing options for, like, when she leaves?
Well, I have a list.
Is there clutches on that list? She needs a clutch if she's going to take a Balmain jacket.
Especially if she's there overnight.
Is she taking this, too?
I don't think so, but if you ask her, she might say differently.
Do you think she'll wear, like, those leopard Brian Atwood ankle boots?
I don't know if she will.
While she's spread eagle? Where is she? Rachel! Rachel being pregnant has really split my brain right down the center. A part of me is thinking, this bitch can handle anything. She's made of steel. And the other part of me is, a baby's about to come out of her vagina. Does she know what that's gonna be like? Not cute.
Joey, even just your scream makes me laugh.
Oh, this looks good. Yeah.
Yeah. So, Chanel cardigan. Check. Vintage Halston in cream and in black.
You're bringing both?
All right, I'll just bring them.
Bring one.
These boots would be good with the sweater.
You can't wear high heels leaving the hospital, honey. Your vagina's gonna be a little...
Joey!
You can't wear 8-inch thigh highs.
I don't think my heels will affect my pee.
She literally thinks that she can get away with this in the most glamorous way possible, and there's no such thing. She has no idea what she's about to get herself into. She thinks the doctor is gonna be like, oh, hi, gorgeous, your baby's arrived.
The problem is, it's such an unglamorous experience that if you feel really unattractive, it makes it so much worse.
You can't look head up, and then you're, like, drugged up, and then you can't get up. So then all these people are coming to visit you, and you look hit the f*** up. I would never let that happen to you. I love you too much.
Joey's gonna be like, look down, look up. Where's the lash clip?
Will we have time for me to fluff your hair and makeup?
100%. I know I'm gonna be a wreck at the hospital, but if I'm gonna be a mess... I'm gonna be a glamorous mess. I'm gonna have bad hair.
I think it's a good idea.
Hat?
I think you should bring hat.
Big sunnies?
Maybe cool.
I can't believe I'm witnessing this.
What would you bring to the hospital?
Sweats and some sneakers.
Well, I don't have sweats, so we're just gonna have to compromise.
Do you have granny panties?
I've posted all the black boy shorts. I feel like I should leave the hospital. I think you should too.
Yeah.
Right?
The list says a loose and comfortable outfit.
Oh my god, you guys. This makes it real. Holy sh**. Oh my god, I'm having a baby. I'm not going. I'm just telling you, I'm giving birth in the closet.
Just listen to your husband. He says you can do it.
He, like, keeps saying to me, like, we're gonna push this kid out. It's gonna be nothing. He's so confident in it that I kind of want to punch him in the face, and then I kind of want to believe him, and then I'm like, I just don't know.
It's so true, though. You were the easiest pregnant person I've ever met.
But I'm fine with staying pregnant and him not coming out for a bit longer.
I feel like I've just whizzed through this pregnancy and been so distracted. And now that I've stopped working, it's hitting me. I'm actually pushing a human out of my body and becoming a mother. Oh, my God.
I feel like you need some fresh air, you psycho. Let's chew some ice or something.
Okay.
I'll chew some ice.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Take your shoes off. Get in bed.
Okay. Hey, gorgeous. Hey. So, I took the liberty of hiring a videographer to make a video.
Baby.
Reality for me in the last couple years is that I can't be in 10 places at one time. So as much as I would love to be with Molly, it's not physically possible.
Is the event here in LA?
No, it's in New York.
Oh.
Yeah.
Way fun.
The positive and the negative of Joey is that he's super confident, sometimes too confident. And with a styling job, there's a million things that can go wrong. So he better not be too cocky about this one.
This is definitely going to be somewhat of a challenge, but I'm confident that I can do it. Way fun. I'm excited. I'm going to make you proud, Mama.
I love you.
I love you too, babe.
Bye, sweet.
Bye. Hello?
Hello?
Hi, Jordan.
Hi, babe.
What's up?
Have you seen Rachel?
Yeah, I walked in. I said, I had a dream that you were swimming in the ocean. You're having your baby tomorrow. And she, I'm super excited for her.
I am too.
So what's been going on around here?
Jen has a fitting in Atlanta because she's filming there. And then Cameron is going to CinemaCon on Wednesdays in Vegas.
Since you guys are so busy, I can do hair and makeup and style classes for you guys. So it's kind of fun because, you know, I like the whole look. I like the whole shebang. Yeah. Hello?
How are you?
Good. How are you, gorgeous?
Miami.
You did? I met Molly Sims a few years back through Rachel, and she's become one of my greatest hair and makeup clients. Every time I get to do her glam, it's like so much fun. All we do is gab like girlfriends. We talk about fashion and beauty and just have a really good time. What's going on?
I'm hosting a thing for Greg Lotus. He's an incredible photographer. Really New York cool, very chic. Because he's kind of a stylized artist. Like, so I kind of want to go 60s cocktail.
Okay.
But, you know, not too sexy, but definitely like a little bit sexy and fun and kind of glitzy because it's New York.
I'm the type of person, when offered anything at first, I'm like, oh my God, that's a cakewalk. I can handle it. You're not even gonna have to worry about anything. But the more time I have to think about something, I start doubting myself. And then I'm like, oh my God, am I getting in over my head? And what about your hair and makeup? What are you thinking?
Maybe do some doughy lashes and some doughy cheeks.
I'll give you a full head to toe.
Okay,
I love
you.
All right, I love you too. I can't wait to see you.
You too, I love you. Bye, Jordan.
Bye.
Bye, honey, thank you. Styling is a whole new level. It's not something that I've done all by myself before without Rachel or the help of Rachel's people.
Yeah, I have a lot of 60s cocktail. This is 60s cocktail.
I love that. It's really good. I'm so obsessed with that option, but she wants like another look as well.
Yeah, I mean, it's going to be a little bit of a scramble to get clothes. You know what would be good is Starworks. It would have some cute 60s dresses there that you could go pull from.
Cool. So will you just set it up for me?
Yeah.
That's so easy. I love pulling. Pulling dresses is really fun for me. I mean, I just feel like I'm in a dollhouse and I can pick as many clothes out as possible to put on a Barbie or something. It's way fun. Bye.
Bye.
Hi.
Hey, how are you?
to see you.
Pleasure to see you.
Welcome. So what are you pulling for today?
Molly Sims. She wants to look super 60s and sexy and fun.
Perfect. Why don't we start with Temperley? I think they're going to have some stuff that fits that vibe.
Okay, perfect. I really love this. It's really 60s and flowy.
Absolutely. It's got that great tunic look to it.
This one's a little more 80s, but it's a good option.
It could go 60s mod.
Yeah. It just depends on the shoe.
Yeah, absolutely.
What I really love about pulling is that because it's for Rachel, they will let me take anything and everything that I want. And I want everything.
I have these great Etro dresses.
I love it.
Absolutely. Super chic.
So good. It's really pretty. Love.
Here's another option. This one's from Amanda Wakely.
I feel like she'll really like this. I kind of love this one.
That's a Julian McDonald.
I feel like I want it.
Okay, perfect.
This one.
That one's beautiful.
I mean, it's not as 60s, but she might wake up not feeling so 60s. She'll forget that. Right. She even told me that she wanted to feel 60s that day. I have Rachel's mentality while I'm doing it. More is more is more is more is more. I just want to make sure that I have all ends covered. I think we have a good mix here of, like, 60s and not so 60s. You know, Molly is not so specific. I started doing her hair and makeup, and this is my first time actually styling her for an event.
Oh, that's so fun.
You know, she totally trusts my judgment. I mean, she only asks for two dresses, but I'm bringing as many as I can.
That's what girls want, exactly. Even if she says two.
But I'm super excited. I hope she likes what I pulled.
Perfect. Well, we'll get it written out for you and get you on your way.
Perfect. Thank you so much.
Hey, gorgeous.
Hi, babe. What are you doing?
Oh, nothing. Just driving around. So I think that we're going to want to memorialize our, like, birth of our child. And
oh, yeah.
I took the liberty of hiring a videographer to make a video.
Crazy. Have you lost your mind?
No, what do you mean? I think it'll be awesome.
Yeah, I won't even let you videotape. You think I'm going to have some stranger videotape the birth?
Honey, no, it's a woman videographer.
Can I come to your colonoscopy with a big-ass video camera?
Honey, we're not going to have to videotape down there.
It's not happening, my love. Not a videographer, not you, not anybody is videotaping anything while I'm in labor or in delivery.
Baby.
Okay?
No.
This is not happening, sweetheart. It's not an option. Bye, honey.
That didn't go over very well.
So you're doing hair, makeup, and you're getting her dressed? How did that happen?
You're really mean.
Rachel's water broke, and...
Out of my face.
It's that time, Neil. It's time for the push present, my friend.
It's exciting, huh?
Oh, God, I'm freaking out. It's going to be any day. It could happen tomorrow. I don't even know. I think I have an idea of what I want, but definitely show me what you
have. Yeah, I'm just thinking, I know Rachel like 10 years. She loves these kind of diamond chains, like this 70s look.
Ooh, this is beautiful.
And it's all diamonds and that. I think it would be cool, you know? So I'm thinking about that. Oh, here's a glamorous bracelet. You know, again, you know, kind of sick jewelry, you know, all platinum and diamonds.
Wow.
See Rachel wearing that? Whoa!
Yeah, I can definitely see her wearing that.
Then I got these chains, because she loves the Chanel look.
Right.
So these are black diamonds and pearls and platinum.
These are black diamonds?
Yeah, black diamonds.
I can only imagine how much this thing costs.
Only $152,000.
Good bargain. I'll take two strands.
So those are real diamonds, you know?
Wowza. Holy Christ. A little out of my price range. It's like $600.
It was really pretty. A locket.
Right.
Picture of the baby.
Oh, that's cool.
Taunt, really sweet.
And you just turn it around and see through it?
And then the baby picture would be there, you know? We'll put your picture there, too, and the baby.
Well, I appreciate that. You know, she has her engagement ring for me, obviously. But, you know, she's always wanted, like, a big cocktail.
She's wanted a big diamond.
Big diamond.
Day one.
I think we need to do it.
Let's walk over to my private little ring selection.
Okay. Wow. There's a lot of diamonds here.
Ever since I met her, she's talked about a cushion-cut diamond.
Yeah, I definitely think she wants a cushion.
There's three beautiful cushions. They're about 3 carats to 4 carats there.
Yeah.
I see that look on your face, like it's not big.
Well, you know what it is? It's like her current engagement ring is 3 carats.
Right.
So I kind of feel like we got to maybe step it up a bit.
I'm afraid to start showing you the bigger ones. You know, we're getting to different numbers, Roger, you know.
I think we got to bite the bullet. I don't want her to come back in 5 years and be like, I want something else. I mean,
this one?
It's sick. And this is cushion, right?
It's exactly what she's been talking about for 10 years.
Whoa. This thing is sick, Neil.
That's between 3.5 carats, 4 carats and 10 carats. She's been talking about a big cushion cut diamond ring forever.
I know.
When I saw her like that at the Oscars last time, she was like putting her finger out.
She's giving you the finger?
No, she's giving me the ring finger. She's like, you know.
She gives me the finger all the time. I want to give it to her in the hospital. Like, I want to be like, baby, I know you went through hell, but hopefully this makes up for some of it. Put it in a box. Shine it up. Let's do it. So? Before I change my mind, put it in a box, and I'm just an idiot. Oh, my gosh. She's
gonna freak.
I'm gonna freak out.
All right.
Yeah, I love you very much.
Come on, brother. Take care.
Thank you.
It's good to see you.
Good to see you, as always.
All the best.
Oh, thank you, Neil.
Joey!
Hi, John.
Hi, where'd you coming in?
What? I'm having a fashion overload right now. I'm putting together everything what for the? Molly for tomorrow.
So what? You're doing hair, makeup, and you're getting her dressed?
Arriving I'm so confused. Tomorrow. Fitting her because we were supposed to do a fitting.
Have you ever fit somebody? Like, do you know how to do that?
I've been in a lot of fittings with Rachel's clients, but I have never been by myself.
How did that happen?
Jordan is working with another client, and the only dress that we discussed together was this one.
I love it.
I'm a control freak, but being pregnant, I've had to release some control, which I don't love to do, but I think Joey can do this.
How cute would it look with this bag?
I love that you're, like, walking and wearing.
It's really good, right?
Yeah. To be Maude, it has to be a lot shorter. Joey's doing us a huge favor by going to New York and dressing Molly, but at the same time, it is a big deal, and he's never done this before, so I can't really help but be a little worried. And how are all these lovely dresses getting to New York?
I'm having an intern come by and ship them.
Overnight?
Yeah.
What if it doesn't get there?
You're really mean. You need to leave me alone. I'm starting to take it a lot more seriously now that Madonna has brought to my attention that maybe I don't really know what I'm doing. Oh my god, I can't breathe. You just gave me...
Don't be scared! I love you!
Oh my god, I'm gonna faint. Hello.
Good morning.
Welcome back. Thank you so much.
The signature right here.
Thank you.
Are you on the fifth floor? Nice to have you back.
Thank
Enjoy.
You so much. Usually when I'm doing someone's hair and makeup, I have like a full hour to do both. In this case, I added styling onto my resume. This is going to be a crazy night.
Hi. Good morning, Ms. Malouf. How are you today?
Good, thank you. Come on in. You could just put it right there.
Well.
Just right in the middle. Thank you so much, Chris.
Thank you.
I'm really excited. My brother Eli is meeting me in my room. I haven't seen him in a while, and he is what I am to Rachel. Rachel looks at me and confides in me and loves me because I'm dead honest with her, and that's what Eli is to me. I have an hour and a half to do her hair, her makeup, fit her, get her into it.
Oh my god, all that at once.
I mean, like, the all three in one hour excites me, and I know I can bang it out because I do that with Rachel all the time.
All that makes me nervous, and I'm not even doing it.
I'm glad you're not coming. Excuse me, you have three things to do in 1 hour. You wish I was coming. You just made me nervous. I wasn't nervous until you got here. Even though my brother and I are, like, 10 years apart, it's like we're carbon copies of each other. We even have, like, the same voice, but I'm a little sweeter.
You're holding the dress that she should wear.
You think?
I love it.
I mean, there's a million options.
That's kind of plain, though.
Really?
I don't know.
Do you think I need more options? I like this one a lot.
I like that one. It's very disco, like Donna Summer. I'm seeing an afro with top and bottom lashes.
I love this one.
The fabric looks cheap.
And then there's this...
For the Jetsons.
I thought this was really 60s if we cut it short.
For Bea Arthur, if you bring her back from the dead.
Really? I think this is so chic.
I mean, it's Rachel Roy. It's major. I can see why you like it, but it's granny.
I mean, with the right hair and makeup.
Well, did you pick out these actual dresses, or did she? They did it in L.A. and you just brought them here?
I picked out most of these dresses.
Oh.
Styling somebody for the first time by myself, it doesn't come as natural.
Well, are you scared you might pick the wrong dress?
At the end of the day, the only thing that would ruin my life is that Rachel saw what she wore and told me she hates it. I would die.
So I totally get her life now, and I think it's so stressful, and this is just for a gallery opening with somebody I'm comfortable with.
Yeah.
I don't know how she's done this for her whole life.
Well, that's why she's Rachel's own.
She's fierce.
You'll be great.
Goodbye.
I have to go.
You're leaving now that you made me nervous?
I'm sorry I made you nervous. You're going to be great.
Thank you.
All right. Call me later.
I will. I'll call you when I'm done. Family always makes you question yourself. And now I'm starting to my pants a little bit.
Bye.
Bye.
See you later.
Hi, guys.
I love.
How are you? Is your hair getting longer?
It's long. I know Molly, and I have a really great relationship with her. I think she trusts my taste.
What are we doing? What are we doing?
So I figured we would start with your fitting. I brought more than two dresses.
Okay, tell me.
You have, great. Like, really cute, cocktail-y dresses. I love this one, too, if you wanted to go for
no.
Like, nope. Well, there's some over here. Here.
And you know what the event is, and
yeah.
Is it Temperley? That's yeah. Pretty.
And then there's this. These are all Temperley, and then there's this one. It's kind of sexy.
No, I'm okay. Good.
I have an hour, and Molly doesn't really know what she's going to wear yet. It could hinder me if she doesn't like anything.
Okay, let's try these three and then Jay Mendel.
Ooh, perfect. These three? You said?
Let's start with these three. It's a little see-through.
Is it?
Can you
take a picture of the flash and see? Oh, I kind of love it.
I think this one would definitely have to be shorter. Sure.
You know what? This goes really disco.
Let me try the black one on really quickly. I feel like my ass is hanging out.
Oh.
See, when things hit me like this, my legs look better.
They look amazing in it, though. There's also a marquesa.
No, I don't want to do it. I hate one shoulders.
Okay.
That's a rule.
There's navy leather. And then there's this Stella, which I thought was really mod, which would look amazing with a ponytail and eyeliner.
Okay, let me try that. I pretty much trust Joey to do anything. I mean, he's been one of the people in my life that's never disappointed me. So I feel like if, God forbid, something went wrong in the whole kind of, like, dressing Molly situation, he actually may not call me and tell me about it. I don't know. I don't love my shoulders either.
It's really cute, though.
Well, I don't want to look too masculine.
I don't think you do. I'm starting to realize why I love doing hair and makeup so much. Because people have so many body issues, it's like not even funny.
This kind of might be fabulous. I have a little bit of a tan. And I even have brought the nude shoes, which, oh, that's kind of great too.
Yeah, to give it a little bit of a color. The last dress that I show Molly is this Rachel Roy dress. And it's like a peachy pink color and has like leather and stoned embroidered all over it. And it's so Molly. And of course, it's the one dress my brother almost threw up when he saw.
It's kind of pretty.
I kind of love it. Do you want it a little shorter?
I like the length. What do you think?
It's such a you dress.
It's such a me dress.
Now that Molly's picked the right dress, I feel so relieved. I mean, hair and makeup is like a cakewalk.
Do I need more powder? Do I need more hair?
No, I think you're good. I think your hair is a really good shape.
Me too.
Yeah, I like it.
Okay, I love you.
Do you feel sexy?
I do. I'll see you tonight. Okay, I love you.
Love you too.
Okay, bye.
Oh my God. I'm so excited to see how people are responding to Molly's look. She looks so confident, and she's shining like the beautiful star that she is. And it makes me feel like I did a really great job. Oh my God, can I take a photo of you really quick? I want to show Rachel so she can be so excited. I feel like while she's home, a full-on head-to-toe miss thing. Work. Honey, the camera dies for you. Perfect. Right?
Molly looks so insane in the Rachel Roy dress.
Work.
Joey did me proud.
All right, I'm going to take a look around.
I love you.
Rachel's water broke, and we are in the bathroom getting together. You know, I gotta admit, it's a little strange when your wife wakes you up and says, my water broke, and then you go into the bathroom to see what's what, wanting to videotape this moment, and she's doing her hair. This is amazing. I'm so happy I have this on videotape.
She's in a lot of pain. Say hello to your new child.
Today. Okay, she doesn't want to talk.
I'm in so much pain.
She's in a lot of pain.
I honestly want to cut my husband right now. Out of my face.
Okay, we're gonna head to the hospital very shortly.
and get the out of my face.
We have to get the nursery done today. I know Rachel. The nursery has to be done by the time she gets home, or she's gonna be so anxious. We should try to call Jeremiah. And in the early stages of labor, Kendall and I have a million things to do before she and the baby come home. And it's kind of stressful, but it's also really fun.
Cancel your plans.
No, I don't have any.
I never have any plans.
Who are we kidding?
Life revolves around RC.
All right. So basically, we have to get the nursery done today because right now all that's in there is the crib without a mattress right. And like miscellaneous items. Uh-huh. I just want to like unpack everything and set everything up and everything be ready, but she's so superstitious.
I mean, if we don't break the superstition, then baby won't have a nursery. So.
Right. I totally respect Rachel and Roger's superstition about not bringing any baby things into the house before the baby, but now that Rachel's been in labor for 5 hours, we have nothing and we really need clothes for the baby to wear. Well, I think now that she's in labor, we can unpack gifts and like make a catalog of what she got so we know what she still needs.
The mattress is still on order. Nina's keeping me updated for when it comes in.
I know Rachel, and the nursery has to be done by the time she gets home or she's gonna be so anxious.
Huh?
All right, so basically we have to go pick out the clothes.
Mm-hmm.
But then we need like an extra body to be at the house to get the nursery ready.
I mean, I can't decorate the nursery.
There's too many pieces of furniture to be put together. We're gonna have to call Jeremiah and have him help us.
Do you think he'll do it?
I feel like he would do it as a favor, and exactly. It's not like anything like ended badly. It was just kind of like, you know, we love you, we just don't have anything for you to do. But I don't know. I feel bad asking, but I honestly don't know who else we could call. It's really awkward to call Jeremiah because we've just let him go, but he started this project with the nursery and he ordered all the furniture, and he's the only person Rachel or I would trust to finish the project and really make it look beautiful.
This is Jeremiah.
Hey, Jeremiah, it's Hi. Marissa and Kendall.
Hi.
Hey, guys.
Hi.
What's going on?
Have you heard about Rachel?
No, what's up?
She's in labor.
What?
I know.
Oh my God, that's so exciting.
So, I really need your help to help us with the nursery.
Okay. I mean, I'll definitely give all my help.
Ugh.
There's a lot of stuff that needs to be built together anyway, brought in there.
Oh, I love you.
Really quickly, the pieces, the stuff that I had ordered, what has come?
Yeah, the crib came, the changing table came.
Of course I'm happy that Marissa called me to come back for the nursery, but I am so confused at this point because I'm not part of the company anymore, so I'm at a lot of loss for words.
Thank you.
Can I get over there?
You can head to the house and we'll run errands and we'll meet you there.
Bye.
Oh, I love you. Thank you so much for helping. We probably have a day and a half between the time that she has the baby and, like, actually comes home.
Mm-hmm.
But I thought we had all week. We should have had a pool and, like, put baths on.
I'm surprised we didn't.
I would have said that she'd be late.
Me too. God, it was so funny. I was at the gym this morning when I got their email. The uh-huh. first thing I did was call Roger, but obviously his phone was off because he's taking care of Rachel.
Right.
Eventually we get there and he's just, like, daddy in full force.
Aww.
Like, already proud of the peanut to come. He's just, like, calm, taking care of Rachel.
Aww.
Like, you know how they say women get the pregnancy glow?
Yeah.
You wouldn't think that they're at their peak when they're giving birth, but Rachel,
aww,
she looked angelic.
She's
yeah.
so pretty.
I'm in the nursery now. I'm freaking out a little bit because we've got nothing. Everything's empty. No mattress.
They're going to deliver the mattress in 45 minutes.
You're going to get bedding and everything.
Yeah, I'm going to get bedding and stuff. We'll send you pictures before we make any choices.
Okay, hurry up.
All right, see you soon.
Bye.
Everything's baby blue. Leave it to us to have the one person who doesn't want baby blue.
I know. She likes green. I bet she'll love that. That's a Roger
this?
Stripe. Wow.
Oh my God, that's
oh my
so cute.
God.
It's newborn.
Perfect.
I feel like I'm part of the styling team today. I'm pulling miniature clothes for a baby photo shoot.
Let me go put these down.
Sounds good.
So we can go back there. We still need to pick out bedding too.
I really like this linen bedding.
Hey, Jer, can you explain the bedding that you liked so I can see if they have it?
I mean, something would be cool with a little bit of a pattern on it.
looking at now, it's like taupe and off-white striped fitted sheet, and then the bumper kind of looks like a giraffe pattern. It's really cute. It I mean, cute. Everything else is really frilly and, like, you know, baby blue. What do you think?
I think it's just as much as you like, and then we can always bring it back.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye.
The hell is a bumper? At this point, I'm really confident that I can decorate anything and complete any task anybody throws at me. The only thing about a nursery is that I don't know anything about them, but I'm going to make sure that it's beautiful, functional, and complete, because that's what I do.
Hi. Oh, my gosh. Jer?
Hi.
Hi. I like it in here.
Really? Because I feel like it's like a minimalist bachelor pad right now.
Oh, it is. He's going to be a sexy bachelor.
Have you seen that leather jacket? Yeah.
How does it look?
Oh.
Cute?
It's great, and it's so much color, she's not going to know what to do with herself.
I know.
If we only had a mattress.
I know.
It's coming. I just got an email from Esther. The delivery guy left about an hour ago, so he should be here.
Awesome.
In an hour.
Wait. Oh, wait, the door's ringing.
Okay. Well, then.
Is it the mattress?
Yes!
Yes!
Coming!
Coming!
We were literally just saying. Oh, my gosh. Yay! Oh, that was so uncute.
Ugh, I wish it always worked out like that.
Oh, my gosh.
I just got an email from Raj, and he would like me to bring a push present to the hospital.
I want to come.
Okay, perfect. They want me to get coffee, too. I'm sure that's the reason.
Okay. Bye, Jer. See you later.
All right, bye. Great. Here I am again, finding myself doing a job for Rachel and Roger by myself. I'm hoping that this project shows them that I am dedicated, I am capable, and firing me was a huge mistake.
There's mommy.
All right, let's see what the damage is. I literally have these jeans. Sweet. Kid has better clothes than I do. I mean, really? The kid has all of Fall All Saints collection? I love that one. I want one of these! Is this Rachel's? I mean, he has better wardrobe than I do, and he's not even out of the vagina yet.
Yeah. Visiting the hospital terrified me. I legitimately had this vision of me, like, flying through double doors, like, on a gurney, screaming, pulling Roger's arm out of his socket, and, you know, like what you see in the movies. I can't do it. My whole life is about to change, and I'm totally unprepared.
Can't wait to meet this little guy. The one thing I could say about childbirth is it's nothing like the movies. You think that, you know, wife has some pain, you go to the hospital, you have a baby. In reality, your wife has the pain, you go to the hospital, and you sit around and wait, and you wait, and you have visitors, you have lunch, you have more visitors, and then you wait. And then finally, the doctor's like, okay, time to push. And that's another hour. So all told, we're here for like, I don't know, 16 hours? Your very first car ride, sweetie. There's mommy.
Hey.
And Aunt Pamela.
Hi. Oh my
and
god, look at his little face. Do you like it?
Taking Skylar home for the very first time, what came over me was the fact that I really have a family. It's not just me and Rach. There's like someone else in the back seat. And his name's Skylar, and he was such a good boy. He didn't cry, and he just looked so happy there. And I just knew that, you know, we were going to create a home together.
Waking up with Sky for the first time
I don't have words to describe it. I just keep looking in his eyes and just wanting to cry. I've never loved anything like this in my life. And he hasn't even spoken yet. I feel like I'm just going to worry about this little boy for the rest of my life.
Hi, Buckaboo. Hi, baby Skylar.
I got to change his poopy diaper. Now he was snuggly. Yay.
Next time on the Rachel Zoe Project.
Beautiful. Yeah, perfect.
Hi.
Skylar. I'm coming, baby.
How's your first day of work?
Dude, you can't f*** this up.
I know.
I can't breathe.
Wrap. I'm anxious to prove to them that I'm the right person for this project.
The fact that I have a child with you, I've never